Hello, fellow beings of Middle-earth, and welcome back to the Remnants of Angmar campaign. This is the fifth episode, and today our goal is to obtain the Witch King. We are going to assault Deadman's DaC, which was formerly known as Fornost. And if we are able to bring down Deadman's DaC, the Witch King should spawn because we have already taken Imladris. And that will certainly be interesting. Because he has a very overpowered general. If he comes with the unit I think he comes with. Move. Deadman's DaC is completely left alone as well. This is awesome. Hirvigil is right outside. That won't really help him much. Now, Azul is of course... Ah, the army has left. So this... Oh yeah, they are coming after us. We're just going to gather together with Agendaur. And now it looks like Azul is quite open, so we might even consider sending these guys with Hunwarn. However, we can't really use Hunwarn at the moment. Now, I think we were sending some general down here. Where's Afanasir? I don't really remember where he is at the moment. Did we send him even further? Oh yeah, he might be. Yeah, he's in this army actually. We could send Morholt down here. I guess having more generals down here wouldn't hurt us. And we are building a lot and our economy is very stable. We just haven't had any... Oh, they have finally taken Oyolad, which means it should finally start to become a bit harder. Now we definitely want to start stacking up units here, because the dwarves are coming now. The Rudar Savages is an excellent unit against the dwarves, because they're effective against armor. And pikemen in general is always good. So we're going to stack up a couple of units here. And I think... Yeah, now we're actually sending more Holt south, but swapping him with Lord Skild would actually be kind of useful, because... Morholt got the Rudar Huskals, which is also effective against armor, and they're a quite good unit as well. Now, over here, let's see. Yeah, this will finish in one turn. I am very tempted to go after these guys, but I don't think if we bring out these guys, yeah, they're going to be mad. We'll just have to wait a bit, and this army will of course be able to start attacking here again. We might not want to hold Deadman's DaC, just take it and get the Witch King, and then maybe even hit Bree, I'm not sure, but Azul I want to take out first. So we could probably send down a couple of more of units. Now this place will not upgrade, so we could go for the communal farming, because it will just bring in a lot more money. On the other hand, we were saving up for mines, but we have finished them most places. In Khandum though, we're getting the blacksmith. We are building mostly, yeah, that's very nice. We're actually building in most places. I suppose we should just build something in Imladris then. We could just go for... Yeah, let's just get this one. Like, farms always just makes it the situation a lot easier. My lord. These guys, they were over here. If we send out these wargs, they will not be sufficient enough to deal with these guys. But when Morholt comes down here, yeah, they probably recruited a lot of units by that time. Let's just send this arch unit. Maybe he can swap with Hunwarn. We'll actually be able to recruit in not too long because we're getting this camp. We'll not have enough culture though. Okay, let's just save the money and let it go one more turn. We'll see what will happen. But we definitely have to be cautious about the dwarves of Eriador. They are no joke. Especially, they are dwarves. But as long as we use armor-piercing units and pikemen, we should be fine. But Angsul is definitely in a dangerous spot now. So that's why I'm just stacking up troops in Khandum. We should probably just make a large army and have it ready to go. Of course, we have Lord Skuld to lead them as well, which is nice. Even though I would have preferred Hunvorn or Morholt to lead it, because they are armor piercing. Definitely, against the dwarves, you just want to use as many armor piercing units as possible. Okay, now we are going to take down Denman's Dyke. Hornburg Siege, Kairos, and wow, that was Fornos assaulted. Yeah, that is Denman's Dyke. Okay, we got, oh yeah, we actually got a new general now. We can check if he is armor piercing as well. I don't think so. No. And he has a lot of armor, so the dwarves would probably tear him apart. These units are pretty good though. But they will not... Yeah, we can just have him in the area and use him when it's needed. But we will see when they are on their way, at least. Now, let's just fill up the fort. This is a very nice army against the dwarves. All of, yeah, half the units are armor piercing. Still a while until we can get more of those units though. Wargs is probably useful to have in that army as well. It's one more turn until we can get some of those. Okay. Barkleg and Nokwaraglaw. Culture is fine here, but I guess some more population growth wouldn't be too bad, and we'll get more culture as well. Let's get some... can actually get mice here as well, but I want to go for town guard. We need to be able to recruit more units in this region. And it was also Fenastrunin, which finished some building. Yeah, we definitely want to go for the town guard here as well. Actually, we can go for town guard here instead of Barkeleg at the moment. Some higher priority. On the other hand, the war camp will be more useful. Let's go for the war camp. Come and get me. That's a large army, and it's probably... Wow! I think the army headed back again. Okay, but I'm going to bring down these guys. We shall slaughter them. Wow, they will actually get a large garrison though. How many turns until it's down? 7 turns. Yes. Yeah, we'll just have to attack anyways. Let us settle matters on the field. Finish them. These guys will bring down Hergil as well. Just get them out of the way. I definitely think that Breeland is our next enemy. But we need to take down Aragorn first as well. But we could very much take out the Northern Dundine in not too long. They don't really have many settlements left, I think. Okay, but I'm going to bring these guys down. I will see you on the battlefield, because we definitely want to watch this battle. We don't have any archers at all, except for these wargs, which is kind of unfortunate. They only got one arch unit themselves, though. But these Dundine volunteers, definitely solid units. We're going to suffer from this battle. But we will get the Witch King, so it's going to be worth it. I will see you on the battlefield. Alright, we're just going to attack them right away. I'm going to show you the bat map in no second. Let me just show you some fighting between these. These guys should be able to pull this off. But they seem to have some troubles here. Let's get in these guys as well. Then we should definitely bring them down. It's a general, and we do have a lot of war units coming in, so I'm not really worried about leaving these guys in melee. Okay, let's just put them like this, and now we're just going to send lots of Javis into them. Let's just give them some wallets, shall we? They don't have any other archer units, so this is going to tear them apart. Javis is one of the most effective ways of bringing down cavalry, simply because... Let's just check. Yeah, a lot of their defense comes from the armor, and Javis are armor piercing, and that's why it works so well. Now, the battle map itself is very beautiful. You can also rebuild this city, and just look at this. It's very massive, So actually you want to attack from a lot of different sides. Oh, it looks like they are coming now. It would be kind of nice if you guys were able to bring down the last Dundine scouts. These guys actually used all of their Javis, which is nice. We're going to try to surround these guys. They do have a lot of strong units, but they don't have any archers left at least. And I suppose we should just spend the rest of our arrows as well. Yeah. So, the Dùnedain Wardens we have seen before. The Dùnedain Warden tiers, they look very nice. I didn't even know they had this kind of design. They have a lot of armor and they have a decent attack, so they're a very good garrison unit. So, definitely our Hillman is going to be a unit that will struggle against Dùnedain Volunteers. Let's hope these guys actually follow us all the way over here. Now you guys should probably run over here. Just block this entrance. And we could probably send in a couple of Hillmen over here as well. In general, let's just get our army much closer than it already is. It's a bit far behind. Yeah, they are very large, these units. They're kind of standing still right now. Let's just give them more Wallis. I think we can trick them into going for the bait if we are kind of sneaky about this. We definitely want to surround them as much as we can. That is definitely going to help us a lot. Alright. You guys go over here. They're like not really going for it, but they're also kind of going for it. It's kind of weird. We might be able if we are just a bit slower. Oh, they still have their general. He's the only one left. Let's just bring him closer. Perhaps it will work then. Just go very slowly. Now hit them. Yeah, it should work now. All of these guys are in pike formation and in guard mode. Then they will do very well. Yeah, it definitely looks like they're going for the bait now. We were really sneaky, we could even send troops around on the other, like around here, and surround them completely. We might want to do that. Okay, let's send in these guys from the other side. And the wargs can keep just sending in some Wallis. Let's put them like this. We can shoot these guys in the back.
Continue like this, we will.
These guys can stand like this. You guys hit the Dundan Wardens. Yeah, they struggle for morale. So if you guys actually go around here, we could probably hit them in the back. Yeah, they are a bit confused now. Definitely looks like. We might actually get some friendly fire. Let's send them all the way around. On this battle map, you can definitely be very sneaky. Yeah, they're sending more troops. They're definitely going for the bait now. They might even send in a lot of their army. I think the look of the Dundine Volunteers is very nice. Very Anorian. Yeah. They have all the reserves we could wish for. Let's see how these guys perform in melee against the Dundan Volunteers. These guys have, they don't have a lot of armor. So it should probably work pretty well. That was not a proper charge. That's not going to work at all. Now these guys were supposed to shoot these guys in the back. Because they are inside a city, so this kind of charge might not work as well. Oh, there we go. That's a nice charge. Yeah, it's actually crushing them utterly. Health unit disappeared, kind of. These guys need to start hitting these guys now. We're just going to surround these guys and make them rout. That's another very good charge. They're magic carping, as I like to call it. And they're just flying into the air. It works out very well. We're going to hit these guys in the back now. Let's just... yeah, they're going to rout. So this is just how we can really utilize Faunus to its full potential. Just surround them over in this spot over here. Now we're going to be able to surround the other troops purely by just walking into them. There's so many. Okay, you guys just bring them down.
The enemy are badly bloodied.
Okay, all of these guys are now coming in here. Yeah, it might be a bit too many. Actually, it works out. Agendar, we definitely want to get into melee so that we can utilize him. Now, we need you to capture a lot of these guys before they arrive at the town center. I wasn't actually thinking about showing you the whole battle, but I guess it was kind of cool for the strategic stuff. These guys are definitely going to do some more charges after a while. Oh, they might even actually completely... oh yeah, they're coming for us. Or not. Oh, we can do the same. We can do the same strategy again. Okay, okay, okay. Now, all of your healmen, just stand here. You guys can go like here. You guys can go like here. You can go over here for now. Agendar, definitely stand on the front line. You will replenish. You guys can stay here. You guys, yeah, you're just standing like you are now. And all of these pikemen will go into guard mode. And they will, like, pikemen are such a defensive unit, so they won't lose a lot of men. They kill very slowly, but they just make the unit very tired. It works out very well. Alright, we're going to send these guys around the units. So let's get you guys over here. You guys over here as well. Let's try to just completely send them around. Oh wow. Let's just bring the battle to them. It looks like it's the time to send these guys around. Yeah, these guys are going to be utterly slaughtered. Let's use our ability as well. Now this is a very nice flanking unit. That's a nice charge from the archers. Now it's your guys' turn. Oh, but this will actually hit these guys because the mass like make these guys go very uptight towards the pikes. But they are kind of surrounded as well. We might need to help them. Let's just send these guys in here. And conscripts, just go up here. Let's bring down... where is their... I can't really see their captain. Yeah, these guys routed. Now we're just going to send these guys over here and just make these last units rout. And there is the captain. Now you guys were supposed to go over here. And there he goes. That is Faunus Orion. Now Dimmer's Dyke. These guys are just capturing the last units. Aguilar, you hit these guys now.
Our men have taken control of the castle.
That's beautiful. We didn't lose a lot either. These guys are still here. Just everyone, just target these guys. Shouldn't take too long then. Could definitely have used Agendaur even more on the front line, because we lost 300. We could probably have lost even fewer men. War skirmishers got a lot of kills. Hillmen as well, that's kind of surprising. Probably captured a lot of routing troops. But that is considered capturing and not killing, so that's weird. Now is this, what kind of dragon is this? It looks like, it has horns, it's kind of a weird dragon. It looks like a Balrog with very large wings, but it was never specified if the Balrog really had wings, I believe. Alright, let's sack this place. Wow, it actually brings us a lot of money. Now, I don't know how this script works, so I think that the Witch King is just going to appear the next next turn. I'm not sure. But we can definitely head out. Oh yeah, we definitely want to build. I definitely want to hold Faunus. It brings so much money. You guys are going to bring down Hervigil though. He got, yeah, he got the normal bodyguards. Alright, I'll fight this off camera and I'll be right back. Now, this is how you stun lock an enemy with arrows. And guys, this campaign has so far been just way too easy. And I really want you guys to come up with a couple of suggestions on how I can make things a little bit harder. One suggestion I just received right now on the previous episode is that I could have to siege out all fortresses. So if you think that's a good idea, please leave a comment about it. Or if you have any other suggestion, please just tell me about it. And I definitely think that we should, the next campaign we play should be a very hard one. So I want you guys to make some suggestions about hard campaigns, because this haven't really been like the Gondorian one, and like the Isengard is kind of hard, but it hasn't really been a problem. I actually forgot the rule that I could only have one general in an army. However, I only used one, so I think it's okay. Afanasir is going to hold Deadman's Dyke. Drangu. I suppose you could kind of just merge a couple of hillmen and have some more space in your army. We didn't really use lots of this army. Now we might be able to pull off some hillmen as well. Yeah, we can leave some hillmen here. And I really want to bring these guys with you, because you didn't really have a lot of cav. And you can just stay as an army for now. The Drangu will be able to defend himself against whatever it is in his path. And Agendaur will move on Anuminas. Or perhaps we should go for Bree. That's probably way better. And I really want to get that shrine, so let's wait a bit with the war camp. What's the culture? Yeah, it's not even any shadow of Melkor at all. Now I think we need more troops down south, so we should recruit some more. We do have an arch unit here. That's definitely not enough. Let's get these guys as well. Morholt. You can actually recruit someone on your way.
As you command.
That's well, very well.
Yes, an order. my lord.
You guys will build a couple of watchtowers next turn. I just don't know how many. Oh, they actually have got a region up here as well, but that will just make another border with the dwarves. Yeah, we'll have to wait another turn right now. Deadman's Dyke. Oh, nice. 1,000 more a turn. That's excellent. The thing now is that we're kind of... We will get attacked from multiple angles. I just hope that the Witch King will now spawn if the script is working and if I'm doing it correctly. Because that's of course new to version 3. And in general, I haven't played this campaign before. I think we have been a bit lucky though with the factions, because it's been really easy. Angmar's Might. That's nice. Witch King leaves Mordor. Wow, it's working. But he will probably not come just yet. It will probably take a little while. Yes. And then he will appear, yes. I guess. Orders. That's very cool. Captain Faelon. Yeah, they will probably take Théodwyn back. Like, we really just need to bring down that army.
As you command. Nothing shall escape your notice.
Right, I just built another watchtowers.
An order. Yes. An order.
I think we're going to go this way instead.
We go no further today. Yes.
A financier definitely needs a larger garrison though. These guys no threat.
Your will, my lord. My lord. I will only as you wish. Yes. Come and I will only.
We're going to send these guys to Deadman's Dyke. And we're going to bring down Aragorn. It's about time he goes down. But these guys, yeah, they weren't too many. If we actually send these guys, yeah, they will take Théodwyn, but we'll take it back in a turn. Morholt, you will hold Finasturnin. Captain Handir and these units will go and take back Théodwyn as quickly as we lose it. We got mines now. Our income is just got another boost. Let's get the leather tanner for the income. Leather tanner here as well, why not? And we were supposed to get a couple of wargs as well. Now the mining networks are good, but these weren't that efficient. Let's go for the mines in, was it Barkaleg? Yeah, let's save up for that for next turn. However, we need more troops to meet the dwarves. Let's get these guys as well. But we'll see when they come, of course. We'll be there in time.
My lord, I will only address you in an order. Yes.
Django, you're going to take a watch on Anominas. Perhaps you could even
an order.
Bring it all by yourself. Ah, here's the barrels. We definitely want to get Bree in not too long. I just don't know how far they have stretched, but it doesn't really look like they have stretched too far. I really want to get a lot more recruitment going on from this place, and we can soon start recruiting units here. These guys were supposed to go down as well.
Your will, my lord.
Guess these guys can go.
My lord. By your command, we can go no further today.
Alright, instead of going for the mines next turn, I think we want to prioritize troops. We want another large army to be roaming around. And Deadman's Dyke is very poorly defended at the moment. And we definitely want to hold it for a little while. But I really want to see if Drangu could be able to capture Anuminas by himself, by just sieging it out. And then seducing the units to attack him. And then we use the Drangu strategy, which have worked so well this campaign. Drangu is such a great general. Now I'm wondering when we will get Witch King. It could be from anything up to 20 turns, I don't know. But it's definitely going to be interesting. Those armies are really scary. But if the goblins were to attack us, this campaign would definitely be a bit more spiced up. Okay, Drangu. Oh, you actually have to move like this.
Move. Yes.
Oh, that's way too powerful, actually.
As you command.
Yeah, let's just retreat him.
Yes.
We will have a lot of units in this area, though.
An order.
We could probably leave a couple. If we leave another war unit, that's going to be very useful.
Yes.
As well as two units of conscripts.
An order. Yes. My lord. An order.
He can actually capture these troops. Yes. Yeah, there we go. That's wonderful. And we gotta take out Aragorn.
Yes.
Morholt, you go down here. You leave. Yeah, it's working out. Just like we wanted. You guys keep on going. Destruction in Angsul. Probably, yeah, we built a mine student, didn't we? Okay, let's just build this and then we'll start recruiting. It's fine. Can I recruit more units here as well? Let's see how much. Yeah, we only have one upkeep. But we can get these guys when it's needed, which is very useful. And we have these guys. We are doing all right now. Okay.
An order. Come and get me, you coward.
Wow, the Dunlendings is here. Okay. I think we should just go for Angsul, even though it's going to be a difficult battle.
An order.
I think we could pull it off. Especially with these reinforcements, it should be possible.
We can actually
attack them next turn as well. It's excellent. Ah, they're going to attack us. This could be very bad. Yeah, it's definitely bad. I'm going to retreat inside the battle. We're not going to be able to pull this off. I will just see you after battle when I have retreat. There we go. Run, you buggers. If we were to lose Triangle, this campaign would certainly be harder, though. These guys are almost out. There we go. This is a very... Yeah, it's a stupid way to get out of armies, but... It works very well if you want to keep your troops alive. For the most part, they might be able to pursue us even further, but most likely we will be able to get away now. It's a very beautiful painting.
They will pay for that.
Yeah, it will actually work very well.
We go no further today.
Now, let's just get Triangle out of here while we have the chance. Wow, the wind is quite heavy outside. It's actually 11 degrees Celsius, and I'm from Norway, so it's still like 20 centimeters of snow around here, but it's finally melting down. I'm looking very much forward to the summer. Very much. I love that time of the year. Imladris is making some solid money now. Baggage train loss. The Witch King of Angmar. It looks like he is here now. And he gets the Legio. He gets the Gardens of Carn Doom. Wow. That's cool. Alright, he's going to be our next overpowered general. So where do we send him? Well, Azul is going down. As we speak,
moving to crush the enemy.
You guys are going to join.
Yes.
Let's just send these guys inside here.
Yes. We shall slaughter them.
We're going to bring them down together. You guys can stay in Theodwin. Now the Witch King could probably be quite useful over here. I think these guys are actually armor piercing, are they? Yeah, they are. And they have, yeah, they would be very useful against the dwarves. Witch King's Ring. We got a lot of shit built as well. Now I want to get the armor. I just want to get some proper armor on our guys now. Wow, that's cool.
An order.
That's a lovely feature for this update. Definitely.
Yes,
okay,
coming.
They're coming now though. Nimradan. You in
battle. An order. My lord. Yes. Yes. Be gone. Come and get
yeah, Drang will be able to get away with the same strategy we just used.
Nothing shall escape your notice in the be gone. Come here if you want to.
Now it's time to recruit a couple of units. These guys will be useful in Fornost.
An order. Moving to crush the enemy.
Okay, this is going to be a hard battle though. It's Aragorn we're talking about here. And they still get the garrison. They're going to be such a large army. And how many, like, they have these guys? They have a lot of archers as well. We could definitely lose this battle. And they have all of these. But if we just surround them, we should be able to pull this off. I will see you on the battlefield. This was another battle map than I thought it was. It is, of course, the Watchtower of Amon Sul. And this is going to be much more challenging because our troops is going to be like, they will have no breath left when they have to climb this long, long hill. And they have like 2,000 Dunedain. This is going to be challenging, but I'm hoping that they will stay over here, that we can kind of surround them over here. This map is very beautiful though. Just look at it. So this is like the only entrance. We're just going to have to push over here and just completely surround them over here and just make them stay inside over here and just surround them. Yeah, that's going to be the plan. But I will definitely see you when this battle, when they these guys have climbed the hill, because it's going to take like 10 minutes for them to get up here. So I will see you then. All right, the battle is starting. Aragorn himself has placed him on the very utter front line. This is very good. We're just going to take advantage of that. Let's just try to get a real foothold here. We're going to use our pikes as well. Definitely just going to trap Aragorn and kill him off as early as possible. These guys is the Grey Company. This is the bodyguard unit for Aragorn. They look kind of cool. Could have looked cooler in my opinion. But they are reflecting how they would have looked, of course. Let's take a look at their stats. They have a total defense of 34 and an attack of 18. And they don't have a lot of armor. So you definitely want to use a missile against these guys. Now the pikes is going to be kind of useful here. Yeah. We're going to struggle. This battle is not going to be easy. Definitely not. Agendar should stay up here just for morale. I mean, these guys should now start hitting Aragorn as well. These guys are going to be slaughtered though. I don't know what these guys are doing. The Dunedain Rangers is kind of doing some arcing shots down the road here. This is going to be a challenging battle, but it's going to be interesting. And I'm doing this for the viewers. Grey Company have probably not lost a single man so far. Okay, these guys. It's a bit hard to get them up here properly. Now, this is a nice situation. Or position, I should probably say. These guys are probably a bit too much bunched up than what they should. Now, these guys are just going to be exhausted, all of these guys. That's the largest concern here. We just need to send out more units. And they're going to be able to get a lot of us killed before we even reach the top. Which is kind of sad. We can always retreat when if we need to. But I think we're going to be able to kill Aragorn nonetheless. He's safe inside. But at least they're starting to drop a bit. Okay, these guys should definitely start throwing some missiles into this cav. Oh jeez, this is going to look badly. No, you definitely want to retreat. They're getting point blank shots into us. These guys should probably start try to interrupt these guys. Horse archers can be terrifying. These guys are keep getting hunted for. I'll just place them like here. You guys start hitting them. If you go into this position, it's going to be a lot easier to defend. And it's very good that we have the pikes up here as well. These guys is needed up here now. The Grey Company is sadly retreating. At least we got some of them down. You guys can now hit these guys. And let's send in these guys as well. We just need to bring these guys down very quickly. Pikes should honestly just go straight through. Because these guys are just shooting at us point blank. But once we bring down the pikes, bring in the pikes, they should fall pretty easily. Now, these guys are... Yeah, they're trying to set up here. We'll definitely try to just go straight through now. It's going to be a blob. They're just using all their archers at us. It's going to be ugly, guys. It's definitely going to be ugly. But they're using a lot of their troops in... a lot of their archers in melee. And we'll have Hunwan on his way as well. Defeat seems almost certain. These guys should try to hit the Cardinal Sentinels. Should probably have had a bit more Hillmen up here. Now let's get some Hillmen up here. These guys as well, let's get them up here. Can you guys even... Yeah, you could probably go over here. Let's use our wargs. They can probably be used very efficiently over here at this front. You guys as well. Let's just run a bit through now. These pikes have done very well. And the Dùnedain scouts are soon to be dead. Can we go all the way around? No, we can't. But they're kind of safe here, and they can keep just throwing javis into the Dùnedain wardens. This is perfect. They're kind of shielded, or they will be in not too long. This is a very nice position for those wargs. But we definitely need more troops up here. Let's get some conscripts up. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, that dream is now crushed. We have these pikes, but they are needed for the time being. Yeah, we definitely need more troops up here. Killed route very easily. This is going to be a challenging battle. No doubts about it. Yeah, these guys are not really paying attention. They will not fire their javis at all. Come on, give them some ham. Okay, now hit the wardens. It looks like a lot of their troops are now gathering over here. That's what we really want. Let's send up all our hillmen now. Definitely need them up here. Let's just get these guys up as well. Let's get these guys. Now it's the time to kind of try to surround these guys. The wargs are probably, yeah, they're working their javis. That's perfect. Doesn't really look like they are getting a lot of kills, but it will at least be used to their full potential. These guys are going to be able to surround though. They have more Dùnedain scouts, but... these guys are actually firing straight blank shots, so let's kind of try to occupy those. You guys are supposed to go over here. And you guys just hit these guys as well. Oh, there's sending more scouts. This is bad. Really bad. Yeah, go over there. They're just all exhausted, and that's the problem. When these guys die, we'll get some reinforcements. Which will take forever to get up here, to be honest. But I don't really have time limits on my battles, because in a lot of situations it will just turn out very weird. These guys can now start pushing these units. Let's get these guys into it. We're still far behind on the numbers game, but we should definitely be able to pull this off. We still have Argendaur and our wargs, which will be used to their full potential in the end. These guys keep firing though. Let's get these guys over here. Yeah, I'll actually speed up the battle and I'll see when we have gained some ground, because this could take a very long time. Phase 2 begins, we are finally taking this place and it's starting to evening out. And we do have these guys incoming as well. We should be able to pull this off. And now I'm just firing straight into this blob. I'm going to start lining up our infantry. This is going to be a hard part. We'll definitely do what we can though. It's not possible to go around here. And not possible to go up on this hill either. We're just going to send in our... These guys can actually start to occupy these guys, because they're just firing to a lot of our guys. And they definitely have a large force again, and almost all our troops is tired. So it's still going to be a very even battle. But we do have these skirmishes, which I think can be very, very important in this battle. Now we're going to send these guys and just make these guys a bit more occupied. We're definitely gathering up a large force here. We'll just have to use as few troops at the time as possible. And we're gonna use the troops which isn't completely tired out. So let's send in these guys. And we're going to try to make them occupied with a lot of units so they get tired themselves as we are. So if you can, never assault this place. It's just way too hard. You just want to siege them out, but I really wanted to see this battle. And it would be interesting, of course. And we're going to take down Aragorn. These guys will just keep firing for the rest of the battle, which is going to be very, very useful. Now you guys hit the wardens and you guys hit the hunters. And you just go as close as you can. You as well, let's get you even closer. Let's get more hillmen to just surround this place. And now I want to send some units around here as well. Let's get some pikes in at the front line as well. And these guys should try to flank. So let's send them over here. Okay, let's send these guys around here. Let's get them over here now.
Defeat seems almost certain.
Yeah, it does seem quite certain at the moment, but we should be able to pull it off. It's now only, yeah, a few percent behind, and Hun 1 is coming with his Barrow Whites, and these warg skirmishes, they're going to be game-breaking. Just, okay, let's just get them up here, and let's just start firing Javis into this blob. Just look at how this is going to be. If you have a lot of wargs in this battle, it can be very useful, definitely. You hit Cardan Riders, they can be a pain in the ass. Alright. Hun 1 as well, get over here. Argendaur, we still haven't used Hun 1 and Argendaur. And remember, they come from two separate armies, so we don't break the rule. This is nice. Aragorn is somewhere, yeah, he's in the middle. Definitely going to target him with the Javis. So you're going to start staying guard mode, and let's try to find out where the Grey Company, they're over here. Alright, let's just empty our Javis. And now we can't really miss. That's the good thing about this. They're going to start losing lots of units. We're actually in the lead now. It's very even though. This is just such a battle. Should get these guys engaged as quickly as possible. Where are you guys? Yeah, you're coming over here as well. Oh, it actually looks like these units went over here instead of around, so we need to take them out. We are losing units very heavily though. These guys are almost, yeah, they're actually out of ammo already. But they definitely got a lot of kills and we're definitely in the lead now. Let's get both these guys over here. I'm going to run now. You're soon out of ammo. We definitely need some more troops here though. It might actually be enough to just hold units here. Yeah, it's very even. If we didn't have our general, this would be over by far. The Dùnedain wardens are such a unit you can just hold for forever. That's really going to give us some pain. And their units are much better than the ones we have remaining. That's also going to be a problem. Now, I think we should just hit them over here as well. Why not? Definitely need to try to surround them as much. I think we need to start. The wargs could probably go around. Let's try it. Let's try that out. You guys as well. Let's try to make them charge over here. No, no, no. They're actually going. They need to go over here. Yeah, then it will work. And you guys as well, go over here. You guys as well. We are, though, solid in our front line, which is very, very nice. If you guys hit the swans, it will be nice. You guys are coming. You guys as well. I'm just going to save Agendar and Hunwon for as long as we can. You guys are going to go straight into here as well. The line is very thin though. We'll have to send in some more conscripts around here, especially. This is definitely going to help us a lot. Now give these Carlin Riders a charge. Show them how it's done, boys. Let's hope this works out. We are surrounding them, so it should work out. So far it's, yeah, we're losing a bit more than them. But we're getting them down. And then after that we can start charging them in the back. And Aragorn himself is so blooded up. He's going to go down. Now you guys go over here. You might actually not run because we want to preserve your... You're so exhausted already. Yeah, you guys need to go in now. You guys keep firing, that's very, very, very well. You hit these guys over here. The lumberman doesn't have a lot of armor. And the Carlin Riders are almost done now. Hunwon is getting targeted. Let's use one of the abilities, just because we have to. That's an epic sound. Right there. Now let's get these guys out. Let's charge with these guys. And then after that, Aragorn is next. He's going to get charged. Now let's just completely get rid of these guys. You can actually just stay here for now. We'll use up all our orcs. And then these guys can come in. These guys just keep firing. Can't really miss a lot. And there they are gone. It looks like, yeah. Okay, you guys are going to be the first ones to charge in. We're going to charge straight against the Aragorn. But they are all positioned at the town center, so they will not rot. I just want him gone out of this land. That's a nice charge indeed. There we go. These guys will charge when these guys are dead. Just going to charge them to their death. Just charge a couple other units as well. Now we might soon want to send in, yeah, I think it's time to send in Hunwon. We need to send in some of these units after all. And there we go, a solid unit finally on the front. That's what we needed. These guys are almost gone. You guys can charge in over here. Just give Aragorn another charge. Alright, let's give him a large charge with these guys. Okay, these archers just run up as quickly as they can. They're going to arrive very late, but it will be fine. That's nice, just occupying them on all fronts. These guys as well, get up here. The wargs might actually not be too slow. And they are Javis, that's just the unit we kind of want.
Battle seems to be swinging in our favor. From such tidings does victory emerge.
That's a nice charge indeed. They're actually slaughtering some of the great company. Yeah, they're going down. Wow. These guys should definitely go in. Now it's time to use our Agendaur. Just cycle charging is very powerful in this game, guys. Now let's use the Black Hand of Mordor. This is a glorious battle indeed. These guys are on their way now. Hunwan is fighting and they're finally starting to drop. We are in a huge lead by now, 6%. This is a real battle. It's a long time since we really fought a hard battle like this in this campaign. I don't think we had a challenging battle so far.
The battle is very much in our favor.
Or we did have one last episode actually. Open one barely survived. That was a nice one. These guys are not far. Yeah, they're still a bit behind. I don't want to lose Hunwan or Agendaur. That would be such a bummer. How's Hunwan doing? Not entirely sure about that. Now let's charge the Great Company. Let's try to make these guys fight to their deaths. We are very lucky. Nice charge.
If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
Nice, just look at these charges. They're getting so good charges. It's incredible. These guys are getting lots of XP as well. How many is Aragorn himself is there in the front line. He will fall in a short amount of time. Let's charge Aragorn himself. See if we can get him down. That's definitely some damage done. These guys are now almost here. And they will be used very good. Let's get them over here. This Hunwan is starting to lose units now. Where are these guys? They're over here. Let's bring another charge to the Grey Company, wherever they are. They are here. This is going to be the end of the Northern Dunedain as we know it. Only Annominas and another region, I believe, they have left. Aragorn goes down to a warg attack. Wow, this is going to send a shockwave through Middle-earth. We have done it, guys. I think it's going to end in a happy situation. Where are these guys? Now you just charge. When Aragorn dies, what hope can these guys have left? That's not a question even. They're just going to be so... They're going to fall apart. Hunwan, charge into them. You guys, go for another charge. And Agendaur, be aggressive. Guys, just stream into these guys now. Just going to surround them on all fronts. They are almost dead now. This was an incredible battle. We lost lots of men, but it was really fun. And we're going to get a lot of more money because a lot of upkeep was just shaved off. But these are the kind of battles you really want to play. They're really exciting. They bring a lot of joy. Okay, these guys are to be brought down.
Be awed by the
wow, it's over. 2,740. Never lost so many in the battle, I believe. These guys were completely devastated. Temple Ward's doing very well, as well as the Hillman. Very good job, Hillman. And what did the Wargs do? 265. That's very well. Yeah, that was a nice battle, guys. And now Isildur's heir is gone. Is this Arwen or perhaps Luthien? I'm not sure. Now I need to check the timer. I completely lost the sense of time during that battle. It was such an excellent battle. This better not crash now. Let's occupy.
Victory!
We're even making 1,000 out of this place. The chieftain of Dùnedain is dead.
Kneel before us, yes.
Yeah, I don't think they have a lot left now by this time. Now you guys are supposed to head up here. Let's see what we got left. Let's just merge these units. Yeah, we're completely devastated.
Yes. Listen up.
Let's bring a proper army into this fort.
Yes.
We're going to make 10,000 a turn.
As you wish.
We definitely don't want to lose this place now though.
No sleeping here.
Let's just merge these with the ones we already have, and here we'll just send these guys out. It's still a little while until we can recruit. We definitely need troops down here now. No doubt about it. Okay.
An order.
I just very quickly have to check how much of the width of how far we have played this episode.
Approaching quietly.
Alright, so this battle or this episode has by far outreached the time we were supposed to go. So I'm just going to end the episode right here. I think we're going to send the Witch King down here now.
Move.
We just need some reinforcements.
Men are spent.
And these guys as well, head south immediately. These guys will come down pretty quickly though. In the next turn we're going to recruit a shit ton of troops. I'm just going to finish this turn and we'll quit it there. Now Drango is going to be able to, he will have to fight this battle. Honestly, I'm going to fight this off camera, and I think we are going to be victorious. But I'm just going to end the episode right here. That was a very nice episode. We took out Deadman's Dyke and Amon Sul, and we got the Witch King back. And the Northern Dundan is almost extinct by this point. So I think it was very successful. Now it only remains to... Now it only remains to take them out quickly and then hit Bree and then take out the Dwarves of Eredluin. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, even though it was a long episode. And I will see you guys for the next episode.